The favor is returned. Native American COVID-19 Relief Fund thanks Irish people for their support. It'd be nice to see more genuinely uplifting stories like this dominating the news. I'm Irish, the Choctaw donation is something we remember with massive gratitude. That the First Nations, struggling with displacement, encroachment, and the rapaciousness inflicted on their people and lands brought about by manifest destiny, still put together a donation for our starving ancestors when the Choctaw themselves were struggling is something that I hope we never forget, and continue to pay forward. Thank you to the First Nations, and I'd love to believe that the federal government will honor their treaties and no donations are needed. But if they are, Ireland at least will stand ready. The people, if not the government. Edit asterisk. It is really amazing to see how much this comment has blown up. It gladdens my heart to see it has such a chord of positivity with so many people. Also, I know that First Nations isn't a generally used term for US-based tribes, but it just feels less racially or prejudicially loaded to my ear than Indian or Native American. Apologies if it causes any offense, but as it's how I phrased my post, I'll let it stand rather than edit it. Although this fund is going towards the Navajo and Hopi tribes and not necessarily the Choctaw, I'd like to think of this as paying it forwards from the kindness of the Choctaw people in the past. This news is like such a great breath of fresh air at this point. Kudos to the Irish. I hope more countries and their governments learn from this example. Disgusting that federal money allotted for tribes was rerouted to the private sector and sold overseas. Amazing that a foreign nation is kinder to Native Americans than Americans. Thank you from this Dakota Sioux, us neighbor tribes are warmed by this. Native Americans have been the hardest hit from this pandemic. I'm Navajo, so I can give a little insight onto what's been going on in the reservation. However, I do not live on a reservation, so I don't know how bad this pandemic truly is for the Navajo. I only have relatives who live near it. My grandma moved away from the reservation when she was young. When the Navajo were forced onto a reservation by Kit Carson, the U.S. government promised infrastructure and running water for the Navajo people. However, this promise has still not been kept, and the majority of my people still live in impoverished communities. Many have no running water, no sanitation, and live on dirt floors. They also live in a food desert, which means many eat unhealthy fast food, contributing to diabetes and other health issues. It is truly like a third world country on the reservation. You can read more about how this pandemic has affected the Navajo community here, https://www.msn.com/en/news/us/in-Navajo-Nation pandemic exposes water crisis and health disparities slash ARBB 1340 GJ, OSID equals SE2. What's worse is that many think that Native Americans just leech off the system when they get the same welfare and unemployment checks as everyone else. Many businesses also take advantage of my people's financial illiteracy, especially loan sharks. These businesses have contributed to a cycle of poverty, and it doesn't help that this administration has been doing whatever it can to cut tribal scholarships, https://onsfa.org/stories/f/Trump administration proposes to eliminate tribal scholarships, from its budget. We need to further educate Native Americans, as that is one of the crucial steps to lifting not only the Navajo community out of poverty, but other tribes too. This is a pretty badass gesture on both sides. The Native American communities in New Mexico are getting destroyed because of this virus, so any relief is a welcome sight. Some reservations have closed off all roads in or out and they are enforcing much more strict quarantine rules like a curfew and things like that. A large portion of New Mexico's cases are in these small rural Native American communities. They are at extreme risk to this thing because obesity, diabetes, and heart issues are a massive problem on a lot of the reservations. My mom grew up in the 50s and has always loved the Native Americans. She loved Native American flutes and I remember her watching multiple documentaries on TV. She still reads books on their culture at 71. In fact, her response to this article was a picture from her book. She's always been ahead of the curve. and is such a wise woman. So it makes sense why she must have felt kindred to them. Always thought it was so random that she had a connection to them, wasn't aware of this, unfortunately, but this makes things a lot clearer. Seeing as the famine to her was just a couple of generations before, donated for her and me. On behalf of me, my mam and Ireland, go rabite mile mate agat, cared. This has me feeling emotional, ah fuck. The amount of suffering the Navajo are going through right now has bummed me out a lot, and seeing this makes me so happy. This is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Thank you to all Irish, from a Lakota. The Navajo and the Choctaw are different nations 800 miles apart. I hope support will be offered to the Choctaw, who made the historic $170 donation during the famine in 1847, as well as continued support for the Navajo people. I'm Irish and donated $200. It made me feel good to think I was returning the favor for my ancestors. This is very moving. I'm glad some people honor memory, history, and most importantly helping our fellow person. The situation on Navajo land is rough. I've seen it personally and they can use the help. Good on the Irish people. It's moments like these that reinforce my belief in the capacity of humanity for greatness. That doesn't necessarily mean I always expect it, but it is always good to remember that just because humanity isn't living up to its potential doesn't mean it's incapable of doing so or that such feats are outside the realm of possibility. Man, as a dude half Irish and half native, can this nation bromance just never die, please? Thanks. Proud to be Irish. I traveled around Ireland with my sister for a couple of weeks and it is one of my most impressive experiences. The landscapes are otherworldly and amazing and the people are absolutely lovely. We met so many people and they are often so kind, generous and helpful and proud to teach you about their history. It honestly doesn't surprise me that the Irish started this fund and the scholarship. It's so inspiring. No nonsense Irish. Easily the most wholesome story of this absurdist travesty that is 2020. I'm baffled that the world-leading economic state called US can't look after their own indigenous people considering they have taken everything from them and lead them into absolute poverty. I just told my co-workers and broke down in tears. This is really uplifting. Thank you. I love seeing things like this. The soft power of having relationships like this across countries and groups is so fucking important. As an African American, I can't ever get over how we treat our native godmothers and godfathers. Without them, a large portion of us wouldn't be here. People are talking about the amount donated to the famine at that time. You should remember Queen Victoria, who ruled over Ireland at the time, only gave £2,000 and even made another European king reduce his donation from 10k to 2k to match hers. The Irish, a great bunch of lads. Helping each other. That's my kind of globalization. This is beautiful. It's so disgusting what America has done to our native peoples. It's a total disgrace and I feel heartbroken for the hardships they still have to face today in 2020. No running water. Really? The federal government needs to pull their heads out of their asses and finally do right by the Native Americans. Thank you, Ireland, for your amazing donations and remembering. An example of how indigenous groups, what some countries refer to as First Nations peoples, often tend to take a long-term view of their relationship to other peoples and their God-designated place in the overall big picture scheme of things. They have long memories.